about 8mm video? Well, this is it. Sony CCD Video 8. It's made to a global standard format.
How's that Sony Video 8 working?
That CCD is beautiful.
Sony CCD Video 8.
Microtechnology is just going bananas in the last year or two.
The future is here, and it's very small. The shrinking electronics universe is dazzling consumers with radios the size of credit cards, TVs that fit into shirt pockets, computers no bigger than calculators, combination video cameras and decks no larger than a 35mm camera. The technological array is literally breathtaking.
Walkman CD players, so you can take them to the beach with you if you like, or tie it into your stereo system at home.
The PC5, which is the newest one that we have, they weren't just happy with having the whole computer on one panel. Now they make it foldable, so it's half the size when you put it in your pocket, and it is thinner than a packet of cigarettes.
Compact video recorders for portable use, Video 8. Not any bigger than a 35mm camera, and yet picture quality is every bit as good, in fact, 40% sharper than VHS quality.
Shrinking along with the equipment is the price. Smaller means fewer raw materials used and lower shipping costs. Consumers are now in the position of getting a better product in a smaller size for a cheaper price. Overall, however, retailers are discovering the biggest selling point to the shrinking technology is portability.
We're such a mobile economy. People are moving all the time. And one of the biggest things they're looking for is something they can enjoy and use personally, but not have to have a problem carry it at ease and slip it in a pocket or whatever they want, a briefcase, and get some good hi-fi sound out of some small microtechnology products.
Retailers are forecasting the compact disc players will be the hot items this holiday season. Close behind, the 8mm video camera, destined, many believe, to replace the Beta and VHS systems within the next 5 to 10 years. The reason? Improved picture quality and size. How much further can everything shrink?
The sky's the limit now on what you can do with them. You can do about anything.
As far as thinking Dick Tracy and Star Wars, it's here today.
The thing is that it's very difficult to try and get across the sound to you now like this when you're listening on conventional TV set, and also we're recording on a conventional tape recorder, so we can't actually get across to you in sound terms what this thing can do. But basically it revolves around five things. The background noise. The background, there's practically no background noise at all, no hiss or anything like that. There's no wow or flutter. Distortion is only 0.05%, which is very, very good, as any hi-fi buff will know. Frequency response is roughly similar to existing hi-fi sets, between 20 and 20,000 hertz. The main thing to say about the frequency response, though, is that it's absolutely flat. No pits or heights in it at all. And finally, the most important thing is the dynamic range is remarkable, 90 dB, which hi-fi buffs will agree is very remarkable.